Autism and Anxiety.
Oh yeah, and these guys.
And welcome back.
And the mood has returned. As have
sorry,
I.
Sorry, I'm going to start this every episode out with AIDS.
With AIDS?
How is...
I gotta...
I'm going to hurt you one of these days.
My parents won't take me to the doctor's. What the fuck is that attached to the underneath of your desk?
Huh? A knife.
So, yeah. That don't surprise me.
Yeah, so now the internet
kind of everywhere.
Knows now.
Like, you could probably reach under anything.
What if it, like, comes unsheathed one day while your legs are under there? It, like, just slices your dick off?
It won't.
What are you doing?
Huh?
I don't know. Open that door on the counter right there. Going into the living room, there's a little thing of a Breva. Will you please hand it here?
As a meditator.
What's a Breva?
Oh, I thought you said breather.
Oh, I thought you were telling me to shut up. Like, it was some, drug for, like, I don't know.
He's an idiot.
He's an idiot.
I have replaced everybody. Screw them. I'm here now.
To go into the living room.
Heard you wrong.
Yeah,
I am also deaf.
Just like, he's an idiot. I just got it myself.
I just honestly heard you wrong. Sounds like I heard living room. I'm like, okay, I can find it.
What if I just, like, chopped your ponytail off right now? I don't know.
I might just kill you.
Austin looked more upset than you.
That's because he uses it.
Oh.
I just wait till all three of you fall asleep and, like, shave you guys bald.
You better wake me up so I can help you.
Wait a minute, are you spending the night?
No.
What did you say?
No, I have a deep irrational fear of staying the night at other people's houses. I haven't had a sleepover since I was 10 because I was scarred at a camp one day. So, like, my
this
parents.
This is getting awkward.
No,
yeah,
my parents.
I was about to say.
No, my parents took me to this camp and I've
old
been going,
Uncle Timmy came out of nowhere.
No. I do have an Uncle Tim, though. But.
Oh.
No.
Wow.
I guessed way too much.
No, anyway, so they left me there, and last year I had stayed for, like, 2 weeks, and so I was like, this year I'll go for 3 weeks. Well, they brought me there, but they didn't tell me that they were going out of town. Like, they went to Washington, D.C. while I was there, and they have a list of
kids.
Speak
a little louder.
They have a list of kids that, like, get to go home on the weekends, or you can stay on the weekends. Well, someone screwed up and put me on the list to go home instead of the list to stay. So all the girls got their stuff packed up, and we waited out front for our parents, and one by one the kids went, and, like, more kids left, more kids left. My parents still didn't come.
She was
like,
sad
yeah,
little kid with
yeah,
a teddy bear with a fucking
come.
Hand in her mouth.
And it was like, sun was going down. I was like, yeah, they're coming. And the counselor, one of the counselors, like, walks up and, like, talks to, like, the manager who came over, who ran the camp. And he's like, they're talking and they're looking back at me. And I'm, like, freaking out. And then they go, one of them comes by and she sits down in front of me. She goes, Samantha, your parents aren't coming to get you. And I was like, what? And they're like, they went away and left you here. And I was like, what? So I called them and they couldn't get back. Or, well, they could have, I think, if they really tried, but they, like, stayed up there because my dad had already paid for everything. And I was, like, there, and, like, every day after that I cried, like, non-stop. And, like, I tried, like, I don't know what my problem is. Like, I tried to figure it out. Like, am I scared that I'm not going to come home? Am I scared I'm going to die?
That mommy and daddy aren't going to show up and come get me.
No, but the funny part is I fucking hate staying at my house, and I love to get out. But, like, if I go to a girl's house or anyone's house and I know it's a sleepover, like, about 9 o'clock, I'll start getting really sick in my stomach, and I'm like, I have to go home.
It's 10:30.
But I know I'm going home. Like, if I came over here knowing I was staying the night, oh, I'd be out of here. I'd be gone. I would have been gone an hour ago.
You'd be fine.
Ryan wants me to spend the night here one day during the summer, because he's like, do your parents know you're still like this? And I was like, yeah. He goes, how the hell do they think you're going to go to FSU and stay there, like, for 4 years if you can't spend the night at somebody's fucking house?
Yeah, true story.
So he wants me to get over my fear this summer, but I was like, nah, fam, I'm good. I'll just, like, get over it that when they leave me at
FSU. You really need to get over to saying fucking fam, because that pisses me off every time I hear it.
Did I just say it?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't realize.
You said, nah, fam, I'm good.
Sorry, like,
I about pimp slapped her while she was driving last time. I was We were going to have a wreck, and most of it was going to be caused by me.
I have a bunch of horrible, horrific childhood stories.
Don't we all? Oh god, what was it? At age 6, I was born without a face. That was my favorite.
When I was 7, my dad had pneumonia, and I didn't understand like sickness at that age, so I thought he was just being a lazy asshole and wouldn't make us dinner, because my mom was upstairs helping her mother, who was staying with us. And I was like, fine, fuck you, Dad, I'll make mac and cheese by myself.
So are just as bad as your parents. You were 7 and you were already like, you know what, fuck you, you're an asshole. Why aren't you cooking dinner? Well, and he's just sitting there like gasping for air. And she's like, fuck you, I'm going to get in the kitchen and do it myself. And she walks off at like 7.
That's what
happened. Like kicks open the oven, jumps in there, and she's like, I'll make you love me. And then she just shuts the oven and turns it on from the inside.
That's a great shit, dude.
No, but... So I'm making this spaghetti, mac and cheese.
Making these paspettis.
Everything was going great until I had to drain the pasta. Well, I was really fucking short.
Like, wrong spaghetti.
Yes.
Spaghettis.
Oh, you mean like Amanda short?
No, like...
Like a 7-year-old short.
I was up to like Amanda here short. When I was 7. And
hey,
so
blame him
I
on that one.
I took the pot and I put it up to the edge of the sink. And so here's, when I was 12. And I didn't get a chair because I couldn't reach the sink. So, I don't know what brain thought process went through it, but instead of pouring the pot forward, I poured it towards me, and like a gallon and a half of boiling water just down the front of my entire body, and I threw my clothes off, and I was like, oh my god, it didn't even hurt, that's how bad the burn was. I burned all my nerve endings, which is why I'm not ticklish on my side, and if somebody like touches me there lightly, I don't even know it. But no, so I whenever I get hurt in my house, well, I can feel you poking me.
Okay.
Like, but if you like lightly laid your finger there, I wouldn't feel it. But anyway, every time I get injured, I think I'm gonna get in trouble for some reason. So what happened was is I grabbed a towel and wrapped it around me to keep stuff from like getting in the burn. And I'm looking at my melted skin and I'm like, it'll all be fine in the morning. I'll go to sleep and then I'll be fine in the morning. This'll all go away. I was trying to tell myself I'd be fine. And then finally I was like, this is not going to be fun. I can't go to swim class like this tomorrow. So I go up the stairs, and my mom's up there, and I go, Mom, can you promise not to be mad at me? She's like, what did you do? And I, like, pulled the towel away, and she goes, oh, my fucking God, child, what did you do to yourself? And she's like, got me in the bathtub with, like, ice water on me, and she's like, we got to go to the hospital right now. And she's, like, dressing me to go to the hospital. My dad's freaking the fuck out. And then my grandmother just comes out of the basement, and she's like, calm down, you're acting crazy, you're not gonna go to the hospital and spend thousands of dollars, and then she'll be scarred from chemical scars because they're gonna scrub her if she has a burn this bad. Let me call your father, who isn't even like a burn doctor, he's an OBGYN. So she calls him and he gives my dad a list of shit to go get from the doc, from the like Walgreens, and my mom's still freaking out, and he comes back with all this like bandage stuff and like bandages me up and puts this silver goo on my burn, and like the next day my muscles hurt like crap.
Oh, yeah.
I swear when the water hit me my stomach jumped up into my throat, but I was like, I can't feel anything now and I burn on my nerves. The doctors are like, literally, I told them one day when I was getting like an exam or something, and she's like, you scare me. I was like, why? She goes, you have no scar at all. That's,
well, you're
that's
lucky.
Freak.
As a man with third degree burns, I can tell you, it sucks.
Yeah.
Okay.
Especially when your feet look like they're covered in scales.
Yeah, because I usually don't do mine till later.
When I got in my
bike
accident.
I just wanted
accident.
To do the big body.
When okay. I did, have fun.
Trying to get you talking.
Have you ever severely injured yourself?
Oh, every day.
I've never broken a bone in my body.
Tried to commit suicide.
That's your own damn fault. That don't count.
I broke my pinky and I injured my back when I was 18. I fell on concrete and my sciatic nerve is now crushed. Hurts like hell.
I fell face first on the concrete. Well, granted, I was riding a bike and I tied a pool floaty to my wrist with a bungee cord and...
Why did you go and do that?
Okay, listen, so I was making my sister's birthday cake for her 13th birthday and she's like, go swimming with me and take a break. I was like,
so this
okay.
was recent.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It was last year. It's been almost like 2 years since this happened.
Huh.
Or a year and a half. And she goes, go swim with me. So I was like, okay. Oh, I wanted to bring the pool floaty, but I didn't want to like walk and I also didn't want to take my car. So I... took the pool floaty, wrapped the bungee cord around it, and then hooked the bungee cord to my wrist. And then I got on my bike, and I rode the bike one-handed with the, like, my hand out to the left. Well, I was, like, starting to wobble, so I went to grab my other handle, but the bungee cord and the floaty came with me, and when the rubber floaty hit the rubber tire, they instantly stopped, and yep. So I went, I literally did, like, tumble cartwheels and, like, face first on the concrete.
You did a superstar.
I took a chunk of my nose out, you can see the bone, I took a chunk of my lip out here. I got permanent road rash on my shoulder now, and, like, my arms and legs were beat out. And then these two front teeth are dead now. Not from the accident. I went to the dentist 2 weeks after the accident, and they told my mom, we x-rayed her teeth, her roots are a little shorter, but that could just be from her braces, but we suggest highly that you go see an endodontist, and she's like, oh, she'll be fine, and she never took me. Well, a year later, I was like, yeah, Mom, my teeth still feel weird, so we went and saw the endodontist, and they're like, you're, like, this close away from us having to remove your teeth, and we should have done this sooner. I was like, Mom, they told you. And she tries to blame it on me every time. She's like, well, you didn't tell me. I was like, Mom, the dentist told you I should see an endodontist. That's your fault.
Right.
Because my sister was yelling at me about it the other day. I go, who told you that I was the one who said I didn't want to see the dentist? She goes, Mom did. And I was like, Mom's fucking lying, bitch, because the dentist told her to take me, and she still didn't take me. So that's her damn fault. And because Dad always rags on me about using all the dental insurance last year that Sarah was going to use to get her braces.
He's like, oh, that's okay. I'll just pay for it with my billions and billions of
dollars. Well, no. This kid at my school who I'm really close friends with, Dad, was an endodontist. And the day after I got my... The day I came back to school after I had my surgery done, he's like, my dad said he'd do it for free. I was like, yeah, nice to know now.
Right. I just got a bunch of friggin' slashes on me. I don't know where they came from. Like this one.
It was last February when I had it done because... It was February 12th when I had it done because I remember coming over here for Valentine's Day. Ryan had to come pick me up because I was still on the heavy drugs. Mm. I don't remember anything from Valentine's Day except that we burned a cross.
Okay, then. I don't think I was here for that.
Everything else Ryan told me. So apparently the day started out, he came and picked me up and brought me here, and then his mom gave me a bottle of soap that I tried to drink because it was orange and I thought it was juice.
Wow.
Then they took it away from me. Then apparently we just kind of sat on the couch, and then I was in and out of consciousness. Like, he'd be talking and just look up.
Oh,
and
I
like,
actually do think I remember seeing you like that. Now.
Well, then apparently he took me to, like, a Japanese restaurant to eat, and then we came back here, and then Hayden came over, and apparently, I love all Ryan's friends, but apparently Ryan said I was being a total bitch because I was jealous he was over on Valentine's Day, but I was on drugs, so, I mean, if I hadn't been, I would have been fine.
To be fair, everyone's jealous of Hayden.
But no, I was just angry that Ryan had a friend over when it was supposed to not be a friend day, but I was also on drugs, so I was being, like, a total bitch to Hayden. Well, apparently Ryan wanted to start a fire, and we were outside, and Hayden goes, hold on, I'll be back. 20 minutes later, he comes out of the shed, or, like, the garage with two sticks nailed together. He, like, sticks it into the ground, pours a can of gasoline on it.
Okay, it all makes sense
lights
now.
It on fire and starts, like, walking around it saying KKK shit.
Yeah, it sounds about right.
Yeah, okay. And then we drove around, like, Camp Jordan for, like, an hour and a half while Hayden was trying to, like, text girls on his phone to find somebody to fuck. All night. I don't know if he ended up succeeding or not, but then he dropped us off at right back here because I was pissed that we had spent majority of the day with him and that I was also on drugs.
And you then, ever want Hayden to leave you alone? Just tell him he's fabulous and he's a nigger and he'll quit.
At about when I got down. Over here at like 10, and at like 11:30, your mom goes, "I'm going to Walgreens. I'll be back in 20 minutes." So she goes to Walgreens. And 20 minutes past, 30, 40, she was gone for 6 hours. And finally I go, Ryan, I kept saying, Ryan, you think she's coming back? You think she's coming back? And like, he's like, yeah, she'll be back any minute now. And then to this day, I still wonder, did she do that on purpose? Or did she just happen to get sidetracked? Because we found out where
Rhonda.
She ended up.
She got sidetracked.
Okay, because I was going to say, she ended up at like Grant's. I was like... Did she leave us alone for 6 hours on purpose? I told Ryan said when he moves out, he wants to ask because he wants to know too.
And he probably just called her and he's like, hey, you can come over. And she's like, okay.
Probably a little bit of both.
Yeah, like, I mean, it's Rhonda.
Yeah.
By the way, welcome to this episode of Autism and Anxiety and Samantha on this playthrough of Amanda. Go figure.
She's better at the game than me. Wait, who's player one?
Me.
Oh.
To be fair, she's a monk. That's kind of a difficult role to get more kills on. I don't know. I remember that time I pulled my groin muscle by falling downstairs. One time, that was fun.
I can't even get to mine.
I was like, I always make jokes that Ryan's gay because, like, at school he does, like, funny shit.
I mean, he totally is.
I know. Like, I would not be surprised if he came out of the closet. I'd be like, oh, cool. I mean, great that I was a cover. I always say you're either the gayest straight guy I know or the straightest gay guy, and I'm hoping it's not that latter. But anyway.
He's just metro. Isn't that a thing? Or, like, you're totally straight, but, like, you're gay as hell.
But no, I was talking to Hayden about it at
Grant's. Leave a comment below if you know what Metro is.
I was talking to Hayden about it at Grant's, and then he walked outside, and at the same time, Ryan's mom came back in, and I didn't know, and I thought Hayden had just grabbed something off the table and come back. So I was still, like, turned around working on food and talking about how gay he is, and then his mom goes, excuse me, I was like, Rhonda, hi, oh, you're here now. And then she kept questioning Ryan all night, and then Ryan got mad at me. He's like, you told my mom I was gay? I was like, no, I was making jokes with Hayden, and I guess your mom walked in, and he left, and I kept making, like, jokes. I mean, I know you're not gay. And then Hayden told me later that, he goes, you owe me, I saved your ass. I was like, why? He goes, Rhonda thought that the reason you thought Ryan was gay is because you tried to make a move on him, and he wouldn't do it. And I was like, what? And he goes, no, Hayden goes, I said,
he goes, you don't have to go to a whisper.
He goes, Rhonda, do you really think the kid that was homeschooled for 14 years and wouldn't even talk to any of us when we first met her, let alone eat in front of any of us, is gonna be making a move on your son? And she sat there and thought a minute, and she's like, I'm just being paranoid. Yeah, you're right, Hayden. And I was like, muscle. Because I would have hated that if she thought I did that.
I wouldn't have batted an eye, because I'd be like, good God, it's just Rhonda overhearing things
again. No, I'd feel horrible if she thought I tried to, like, make a move on someone I didn't. Because I'd be like, no, it's not like that. I was just, like, go to school with him for a day and walk around with him. He, like, starts holding guys' hands and, like, caressing their arms and giving them hugs and, like, saying gay shit to them. And he even says, like, at least once a week, yeah, if I was gay, I'd date Bowman. And Bowman will look at him and, like, do something sexual.
I mean, like,
he'll give him, like, the fuck me eyes.
Yes! And he'll do, like, he'll mouth, like, really
gay jokes and shit before, but that's, like, pushing it.
Have we trained Ryan too well?
Sometimes. I think he's gay.
I think it's JC's doing.
Yeah, that's true.
And Wesley, oh my God, when they're together, it's JC. They do, like, such gay shit. Like,
well, I'm pretty sure Wesley is gay. Like, that's not even a shot. I'm just, like, kind of convinced at this point.
I got really upset one day because Wesley called me out of the blue for nothing. He just needed someone to talk to or tell. He goes, we were talking about something, and he goes, yeah, I just, I had my experience with a guy. I was like, what? He goes, yeah, the other day. Like, it just wasn't doing it for me, though. I was like, who was this guy?
Wait, what?
And he just smiled at me, and I was like, if you fuck my boyfriend, I swear to God I'm gonna kill you if you fucked my boyfriend. And I called Ryan. I was like, did Wesley tell you he just had an experience with a guy? He goes, no. I go, don't tell him I told you, but I just wanted to make sure it wasn't you.
Well, good job, Wesley. Your entire story is out on the internet for everyone to know.
Yeah. I was just saying, now that's all over the fucking
world. I bet he doesn't watch this and none of his friends do, so we're good.
That don't matter. If I know, for some I know reason, 3 different Wesleys. We end up getting friggin' millions and millions of views. You think that
he'll laugh about it, but no, I know 3
Wesley
different Wesleys.
Oh, Wesley will absolutely love this story.
I know, but Wesley, we're called Wesley, Redder, and Wesley.
Yeah, just put their names out there. Stop being stupid. For God's sake.
My social security
think
numbers.
Of the children.
Anyways, I think the worst I hurt myself, excluding self-suicide, was,
the self-suicide, not the, group suicide. Yeah. Wasn't the Kool-Aid version.
Yeah. I was chasing down a kid who stole my, skateboard on
my bike.
I don't know what you're talking about. And, my back brakes didn't work. So I barely tapped the front brakes.
And you went
downhill, and I flipped and I smashed my ribs against the handlebar.
That's what happened to me, but like.
And I cracked my rib. Actually, never mind. I totally forgot about this. Me, JC, and Ryan were playing basketball, and I went to duck, and JC went to do the same thing or whatever. Anyways, and I had to, like, maneuver in the air to not hit him.
Oh, so this is a time when you two, like, almost smacked into each other?
That
was funny.
And I landed on the curb wrong, and I broke my foot.
Oh, my God.
Okay, no. This is a different time, because I remember that same thing happened when we were at the church one. Like, we were up there, and,
yeah, you weren't there.
Yeah, no, this was, that part was great, though, because, like, JC's dumbass was on, like, the higher end part, where, like, you know, I think you were there, you saw that, like, where he was, like, trying to dunk off the freaking, his dumbass, damn, you broke his feet.
I am, like, scarred for life. I can never ride another bike. I've got another horrible bike story. So my dad bought me my first bike, and we were going bike riding.
Okay, after this, Amanda has to tell the story.
Okay. And we went down this big hill, and I've been down it before on my brother's old bike all the time. And,
John, check on him, please. Oh. Will you check on him?
And I was like, before we left, I was like, hey, Dad, is everything good on the bike? He's like, yeah. So I went down the big hill, and I was, like, going fast. And all of a sudden, I'm, like, on my handlebars. The handlebar, it was attached to the bolt. It just flips down. So now I'm riding a two-wheeled unicycle. Well, a dual cycle, because there's no handles.
A bicycle? And,
no, it's right next to this. I don't know who designed this. The path is right next to, on the left side, you have a train, and on the right side, you have a four-lane highway. So my brain as a 10-year-old had to go, okay, and the train was coming, unfortunately. Do I dive left and land on the tracks and try to get up before the train hits me, or do I dodge right into traffic, head oncoming traffic? And I thought, and I was like, in the moment, I just like put my hands out and like kind of like, Jesus, take the wheel. Like, who cares? And I like my wheels.
You just started taking off the ground for a second, like your arms caught the altitude, and you're like,
My bike just lifted off and I ascended to the heavens, third dimension. No.
They found you like 3 years later with wings strapped to your back.
My bike started wobbling and I tumbled and barrel rolled into some like grass, and my body landed half on the road, and somebody like luckily swerved out of the way in time.
So are you guys like hunting Queen Shelob from friggin' Lord of the Rings or what? Like, I haven't been paying attention to this game at all.
So, Amanda, tell us a story.
Okay. You sound like Michael Jackson, Dylan.
You tell us a story. You don't tell us a story, and we continue.
I one time killed a man with my own teeth.
I'll take the torture.
Tell us a story.
My brother ran my foot over with a quad car because I wouldn't give him a milkshake I had.
I ran over a fat chick one time.
Didn't you tell me you almost killed a bitch? You were just talking and you randomly threw in this story where you were choking a bitch and you got a little too into it and you looked down and her face was blue. And I said, I hope she's okay. Is she okay? And you go, yeah, unfortunately. I was like, whoa, bro.
Bruh.
Like, I mean, that was a little too much information. Like, I was like, why is he telling me this?
I don't care.
Chasen's house has a lot of weird stories.
It wasn't Chasen.
No, I was just thinking that one you were telling me. The incident with the pool.
My dog, we used to give him extra pizza, that pizza that we had in the fridge, and he'd never eat it in front of us. And we never knew where he went with it, so we just assumed he didn't like to eat it in front of us. Well, when he died, we were digging up the backyard to bury him, and we found all the pizza. He had, like, buried it because he hated it. But he didn't want to be rude.
Wow.
How the fuck did we go from almost choking a woman out to a pool to a dog burying pizza in a backyard?
Well, actually...
There's a thousand amounts of...
Pool parties have pizza.
Actually, it was... I ran over a fat chick once, and then it went from me almost killing a chick because I got a little too into it.
We've had enough conversations where one can overlap the other and be forgotten at this point. Like, what the...
That was definitely the best one so far.
Now we're going to tell the story about that time I fell off the stairs and landed on somebody.
Oh my god, when my brother was little, he would run around with his blanket on him like a ghost. And one day my mom heard... And she like ran into the living room and he had tripped down the stairs, tumbled and smacked into the wall and kicked a hole in it. Oh. And he was like 6 years old and he's crying and my mom's like, oh my god, Michael snapped his neck and he's dead.
I got upset.
Ryan thought Michael was adopted for, like, the first 7 months he knew me, but he said, he finally asked me, he goes, Samantha, can I ask you something? Yeah, what's wrong? Is Michael adopted? What the fuck? Yeah, I mean, I didn't want to say anything if you guys hadn't told him yet. I was like, think, no, he's not adopted.
We just wish he was. You can only put Old Yeller down so many times, but he keeps coming back. It's like a plague.
When my mom calls me a bitch, she sometimes says I'm adopted.
Yeah, you know, like the fat chick. Well, she was cool.
As a joke.
But was honestly, no, it wasn't Emily. It was one of her friends.
I was in the right ballpark, though. Emily that's the
really,
worst part.
Emily was really fat.
She's just kind of over.
Yeah. She's just kind of chubby.
She okay. She cool.
Yeah. Like, she looks good now. Like, she lost a lot of that weight.
Does she still have that terrifying face?
No, not really.
Okay, cool.
But anyways, I haven't seen her in person. I saw her face, but...
You get close. I know your feet can't touch the ground while you're sitting on him, but if you're sitting in the chair, can they touch the ground?
What are you talking about?
By myself? Yeah.
Okay, I was about to say, it looks like a little kid in a high chair. I can't touch the ground with my feet.
This is what happens when you don't tell your own story. Someone
shut the fuck up, Dylan. Just shut the fuck up, dude.
Everybody chill. Baby, sleep.
I told you you don't know what that kid will sleep through.
I'm sorry, did I hurt your feelings?
No, that's the first time.
Oh, I thought you were crying. I was about to start crying.
No, that's just the first time.
I'm pretty sure my face turned blood red, though.
Oh, yeah. These Diablo playthroughs are my favorite.
I have no filter. I just kind of say whatever comes to my mind first because that's how it was when I was
because I don't have to play for once.
Did you suddenly just get injured in here? We're talking about injuries.
Oh, look, my whole body just explodes into blood all the time. I'm used to it at this point.
Oh, God.
It's far too late for that.
I feel horrible now.
Tell Viola I'd like to get a picture.
Why would you feel horrible?
Because, like, he trusts me with all his secrets, and now I'm a horrible bitch.
Well, we don't know him, so it don't matter.
Yeah.
But all
I won't
of his
say
story,
what friend, though.
All of his
because I have no friends, because I'm lonely. I've got one friend. She moved to South Carolina, though, and abandoned me and turned emo and gay. Then she told me she had a crush on me when we were friends, and I was like, okay, bye.
Gemo.
Wow.
Yeah, and then I thought, after she told me that and hung up, I was like, I slept in a bed with this girl for 10 years.
What happened while I was...
No wonder
that's what
you're
I was
like
wondering. No, there was... Never mind. That's too bad of a story.
This is a channel called Autism and Anxiety. There is no such thing as a bad...
We were just talking about a bunch of funny shit. Anyways, the fat chick rolled over.
What did you... Wait, my question is, you didn't specify. What did you run her over with?
My car.
Like your actual car?
Yes.
Wait, we didn't
like, did you go over her?
Yes.
Like, her whole body?
Yes.
What the fuck?
She had excess cushion. She's fine.
Look. I've explained this on the channel before.
If you run over her ovary, she's never having kids.
What happened was Emily got in the passenger seat, and she was getting in the back seat. Well, I heard the back door slam, and I was like, okay, she's in the car. So I started taking off, and all I hear is, wait, and I look back, and she got, her foot got hung on the tire, and then I see her, basically.
Really yeah, she didn't have to go to the hospital or anything after that. That was
nope,
so weird.
She was perfectly fine.
Like, alright.
Yep, she got up, and
let's go.
Everything was good. I was like, are you sure? I was like, you don't want me to take you to the hospital or anything? She's like, no, I'm perfectly fine. She's like, I can't believe I was just run over by a car. I was like, I can't believe I just ran you over.
And then somebody else popped in the corner. I can't believe it's not butter.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, no, basically. Like, everyone was freaking out. We got the Tommies, and we're out. Like, my first thing, I was like, dude, I just ran over the kid with my car. And they were like, well, I don't believe you. She was like, no, he ran over me. And I was like, yeah, that was fucking
Are you eating the bandage you took off your face?
Yep. Gotta get some sustenance. No, it's
oh,
just
okay.
In plastic.
I was like, what the fuck? I saw you peel it off. I was like, did he eat it?
Nah, out there do I.
No, but Amanda's like scarred for life after meeting me. No, but I'll tell that story. Okay, you know what melatonin is?
Oh, honey, I can't
it's
take
like
that stuff.
It's like a vitamin that helps you sleep. Well, my friend and I would take like 8 of them because it was like funny if we tried to fight staying going to sleep. It's hilarious. And so, like, technically, I guess you could call us, we were high. And so we're sitting at my desk and I was like, whoa, wait, I found out this new cool thing because I could sketch myself on my computer with my phone, so I Skyped myself on my phone on my computer. I was like, we took turns putting the earphones on, and we were like, whoa, we can hear ourselves, but it doesn't line up with our talking. We're just being dumb. And she's sitting next to me.
So just another day in the life,
I take the headphones off, and like, it's a small bench, so we're like really close together. And she's leaned over, she's singing, nigga, 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 nigga. And like, she just kept singing that owner, and she started to slow down singing, and she looked at me, like, I kind of looked at her, and she slowed down her singing and started leaning in closer, and I was like, what the fuck's happening? And I started leaning in closer, and then like, we're almost like, yeah, and then she goes, I go, wait a second, what the fuck are you doing? And then she falls off the bench. I was like, oh my god, did you just try to kiss me? She goes, no, you, I thought you were trying to kiss me. So I was like, oh well, might as well go with it. I was like, no, I thought you were trying to kiss me. And I was like, is this gonna happen? That was my almost gay experience.
Might as well go with it.
Then I kept yelling at her about it, so she, tied me up and threw me in my living room and left me there all night.
I thought I was going to go in a whole different direction.
I know, right?
My mind went about 8 different places, and tied me up was one of them.
Well, no, first she hit me in the face with a book, and I was like, what the fuck, man? And then
that was the other direction.
Then she took a she took a sweater and tied my legs and hands together and left me in the living room.
Oh, so she's into that kind of kinky. I gotcha.
Our type of kinky.
Mm-mm. Well, then she called her boyfriend and was like, haha, look what I did to my friend.
Mine and your kind of kinky. Okay.
We just have a similar version.
No, but like, then she called her boyfriend and was like, just coincidence. Haha, look, this is hilarious. And then he's a sadistic bastard, and he goes, wait, I have an idea, Emma. And I was like, good God, please,
like,
no.
Twice as big as your head. But I have like a big head anyway, so. Can't see nothing, can you?
I can see.
Honey, it gets worse, but I don't know if I should continue.
I have to use reading glasses anyways.
Me too.
I didn't do anything.
I have to use video game glasses.
I've got less than 2 chapters in my book left.
I know.
Well, next time, everybody.
I'm not gay, I swear.
This episode has gone off on such a tangent. I say we call it here because everybody's losing their damn minds.
Most artists are gay, but I'm not.
Oh my god.
They're all on Tumblr and they're gay.
She's only half gay.
3 different genders.
Lord help us all.
She's a
half gay. That would be called bi.
She's a necrosexual. She's only into the undead.
The undead. That would be anti-necrosexual because necro means necrophilia. Which
okay.
Is
goodbye. Bye.